Hello everyone. Today I want to talk with you about main Magento 2 performance bottlenecks, and my topic will be about how to avoid these bottlenecks on real projects. First, let me please introduce myself. My name is Igor Bondarenko, and I'm a head of business development in Nekla. I'm worked in IT more than 10 years. In the last 2 years, I'm involved in Magento development. I think some of you meet me on another conferences, and yeah, nice to meet you here. I think this topic could be a little bit obvious for you, like technical specialists, but I think it's really hard to underestimate loading times of your websites. According to Radway Research, electronic e-shops which loads 3 seconds in comparison with stores which loads only 1 second has 22% less views and conversion. And if we have talk about stores which loads about 5 seconds, this market has about 38% less views and conversion. So, the faster your website works, the more money you get. And our company is developer of Magento Store Monitoring application. And I say that not to advertise this product. We just collect all requests which we receive from customers and users of this product, which ask us to investigate why the stores have a really bad performance. And during these investigations, we prepare a list of top issues which grows down Magento 2 performance. And now I want to share it with you. The main issue which related with performance is server. Server is the core of your store. And really, this is really important that if you choose bad server and implement all steps which I describe later, I think you don't rise to performance, because server is really a core. What I strongly recommend you, I recommend you to don't use cheap shared hostings, because these solutions tend to overcrowd the power to a huge amount of people. And if you have, for example, Christmas sale, I think your site will work very slow, because this server is not, this sharing hosting is not scalable. I recommend you to use cloud solutions like Amazon or Microsoft Azure or OpenStack Cloud. That's a powerful services which have load balancing, and if you need some more powerful servers, they grow automatically and balance your loading. And when the loading is going down, this power is off. Or you could use a powerful dedicated server, but anywhere, it doesn't matter what you choose, cloud server or dedicated server, ensure that it meets system requirements which Magento, with Magento 2. That's a very short list of requirements, but you could find a full list of them on Magento website. This requirements is maybe 2 or 3 pages, and it's very important to ensure that your server meet them. Let's have a talk about Magento configuration. The first issue, the top issue we found on our customers, they don't use flat categories and products. I really don't know why Magento 2 don't turn on this feature by default. But I strongly recommend you to turn this on every store. This feature reduce the amount of joins when you show catalog or products. and reduce complexity of your SQL requests. And if you turn this on, I think your store will work faster than previously. The second great issue is minifying of JavaScript files and CSS files. When customer asks us why my store works so slow, just open UFlow, something like web page test, send a link, and in analysis results you will see a huge list of JavaScript files which loading one by one. And Magento from the box now supports the minifying and merging of CSS and JS files. As many files you have, as less files you have, less HTTP requests using for loading them. The next great thing which people don't use, but I don't know why, is CDN, Content Delivery Network. Content Delivery Network is an interconnected system of cache servers which use geographic proximity as a criteria for returning content to your customer. There are a lot of types of CDN now available, and just have a look through the features provided and geographic coverage and apply this to your Magento 2 store. This feature also supported from the box. You just need to open configuration and provide a base URL for your CDN cache services. And caching. Sometimes I see that customers have disabled cache, and I always show them a picture like this. When you disable your caching, every time the client opens your site, this site opens from scratch and loads all the files. And now Magento supports full page cache from the box, don't forget to turn it on. But full page cache is not always suitable. For example, pages with dynamic content like checkout, like your basket, couldn't be cached by full page cache. Here, I think there are a lot of extensions which provide you a block cache, and you could cache only some blocks on these pages, and this didn't bring to conflicts with caches. The next great issue with performance is image optimization. Sometimes I find websites where customer upload and catalog products with images, so BMP files, 10-20 megabytes per file, and he asked, it's so slow, how to improve the performance? Compress the images and select a proper format. For example, if we have talk about products and catalog, I think that the best is using of JPEG files, because it's a good compromise between quality and image sizes. But according to layouts and teams, it's better to use SVG files or PNG files. One more issue is related to update indexes. Magento should update indexes automatically, but I think all of you work with Magento 1 and you know that they don't do it. So, don't forget to time-to-time update indexes. Now, in Magento Marketplace, there are some extensions which allow you to update indexes by schedule. That's very useful for customers, they don't need to check it manually. And I recommend to use something like that. One more feature that really slow down Magento 2 sites is a huge amount of extensions that customers don't use. Sometimes I find about hundreds of extensions and I ask, do you really use it? No, I just download one, download two, download third extension. I have a look, but I don't like it, and I find a fourth extension, it works. I always ask, why don't you disable these extensions? Because every time your store loads, this HTTP requests and loading time of your store increasing. And many people don't know that it's possible to disable an extension. Also, it's not very clear, because you need to go to advanced lock and disable an extension. This feature don't disable a lock, this feature disable an extension. That's Magento. And don't forget about Magento updates. Magento team is consistently working under Magento performance increasing and improvements, and don't miss Magento updates, it's really important. And key success factors on my point of view is using flag categories and products on your store. Don't forget to merge and minify CSS and JavaScript files. Implement and use CDN, don't forget about it. Enable caching. Optimize images and select a proper format. And don't forget about Magento update. And really don't forget, these things doesn't work if you select server which don't meet your and Magento requirements. That's all, thank you for attention. Questions?
Can you go to the disable module disable?
Sorry?
Can you go to the module disable slide, please? I hate to correct you, but you only disable the output. You cannot disable the module access. I hate to correct you, but it's really important because customers think the same, but you disable only the output. Like, you know, if you have a fancy design or some visualist add button, you know, you disable only the output from the module access.
So you should
have an update file and
disable. Correct,
yes.
Okay.
Yeah, only to be clear.
Okay, thank you. Any more question? Okay.
Thank you.